Denver Broncos Mile High View, no commercials, no bullshit. So I just want to say something before the San Diego game. I do that analysis. Something that's a bit disturbing to me, and that's this idea that the talking heads, getting the sports radio, but mostly like writers, this idea of playing lock in order to, let's see what we have, which really, let me translate this for you. Let's see if we can throw them under the bus and start pounding the table for the draft a quarterback in the first round of the draft, as if that's going to solve any problems, all the problems that the Broncos have. And the reason that I'm even making this is because it was, again, James MerIlatt, which is on the Mile High Report, which a bunch of like-minded thinking, you know, people on there. But what was really transparent, I guess what was really egregious to me and disingenuous, was when MerIlatt said, well, you know, this would be a great opportunity like Goff got. You know, Goff was able to make all these mistakes. And I thought to myself, you son of a bitch, if Locke is thrown in, and obviously on a crappy team with a crappy O-line and a non-existent defense, he's not going to do very well. Now, who the fuck does he think he's bullshitting? Remember, there's no bullshit here. This is a no-bullshit zone I run. You know MerIlatt, and I know that as soon as Locke starts making mistakes, and let's not kid ourselves. He's on a crappy team, so he's bound to make a lot of mistakes, okay? And he's going to be put in a lot of bad situations because his defense sucks. So we're really setting him up for fail, which you say that's what Goff did. He failed. He made lots and lots and lots of mistakes. But let's not bullshit ourselves here. The second he makes all these mistakes, you're going to be the very first person that's going to be pounding the table that the Broncos draft a first-round quarterback for in the 2020 draft when all these quarterbacks come out. And, you know, Broncos right now are projected to get one of the top quarterbacks that they keep losing. Okay, so why don't we just draft the quarterback? Why don't we just forget playing these games and just draft the quarterback first round? Just get it over with. Okay? Let's forget all the other problems with the team. We'll just get some guys that are okay. Get some okay guys maybe to fill in the not so okay guys that we already have. And see if we can get this muddling in the middle group, you know. See if these quarterbacks can take a muddling group and somehow sprinkle magic fairy dust on them and make them much better players, because we always hear this all the time. We can't just get good players. We have to make players who really aren't good better than they really are. And I think that's a load of crap. I think that either you're good or you're bad. Joe Flacco, he did make the line look better. He didn't make them better than they are. He only made them look better because he finally was getting rid of the ball fast. Like he should. I mean, let's face it, Scandrello, he can't run a play-action system with this offensive line. They just don't have the time to, you know, they did some good misdirection stuff, but I don't know if they can sustain that. Scandrello got away from it quick. I think Scandrello's system, what he's trying to do is out the window just because he doesn't have the line support. Do you have to get a first-round draft pick quarterback? I mean, look where Daniel Jones. If it hadn't been for the Giants' due diligence, they would have never, nobody would have drafted him because he wasn't hyped. I don't know, everybody's got to go with the hype. You know, I'll give the Giants credit for not listening to the hype and going with, you know, what their eyeballs was telling them based on their system. And all the people like, oh, how, look at this. Oh, Daniel Jones. Because he wasn't hyped. You know, so I just think it's very disingenuous when sports people go out there and say, "Oh yeah, he can go and fail. This would be good if he failed. Right now, it'd be a good time." You would put that tombstone on his head and bury him as fast as you could, and you would be demanding that Elway. Everything would be, we got to draft a. Forget all the other stuff that why we're in this mess. Drafting a franchise quarterback to play on a shit team without a chance, like the Cleveland Browns of 30 years of doing the same formula, instead of building a team you can put a quarterback in. If I'm not mistaken, Kansas City wasn't on a three-game win or a one-game win when they got Mahomes. They were a playoff contending team who just went up because, I guess, Mahomes himself wasn't hyped. We don't know, you know, if you finally make the effort to put good players and veterans on a team and then have a quarterback that wasn't hyped, geez, they could be the next Mahomes or Daniel Jones or whatever. That is possible, you know. But you got to make the effort to put the play, to get the players in the first place. Why don't you just get some offensive linemen so Scandrella can actually run his offense? Right now, it's got to be a Brady-type pocket quarterback quick throw offense. You haven't really got much of a choice because the line's that bad. You know, why not just keep Flacco and Locke, build the team up? You can always go up and get a quarterback at some point. Let's get the clear the record here. I didn't want Locke. I didn't even want Locke, and I have to defend him from his own fan base. So, again, this is the place where quarterbacks come to die. The fans are more than willing to put tombstones on the top of quarterbacks, bury them, and that's it. And that's what they're really trying to do with Locke.